Well, talk about a weird night last night, I tell you. Why does this say 10 o'clock? So, anyways, yeah, this is what I'm saying. Like, so weird. Yesterday, it started off yesterday with, being, like, a whole bunch of things were kind of, oh, shit, I need my wallet. I left my wallet downstairs in the truck. I can't go around without the wallet. I need my license and all that. Anyways, yeah, talk about just super weird stuff. Yesterday, it was kind of glitchy at work. And then email was acting up, and all things were kind of acting up, and things weren't working the way they were. And then after that, by yesterday late afternoon, I get home only to find like all my notes on my iPhone just all of a sudden disappeared. I didn't do anything. I was checking them throughout the day because in the notes application, right? So they just all disappeared, right? And then come home trying to figure that out, kind of messing around with it and whatnot, and reading different reviews or different reports as to, you know, what it could be, how to fix it, yada yada yada, blah blah blah. And then all of a sudden, holy smokes, it's fogging up. My TV kind of shuts down. My main TV in the living room, poof, gone. And I'm just like, uh-oh, what's going on there, right? I'm like, oh no, shit. Sage and his too much dancing and throwing things around or something like that kind of finally, you know, blew the TV up. But it was strange because the little light was flashing and da-da-da-da-da. And so doing some tests and whatnot, and you'd kind of walk in front of the TV, kinda, and the TV would come on. And if you'd stop and stay there, it would stay on. Oh no, actually, sorry, not this one. The big TV, it was just flashing, 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 and then it would turn on and then off, and on and then off. You wouldn't even get to a picture, and it was working perfectly fine. Maybe I'm the bad juju. So I disconnect the TV. I'm like, okay, I gotta go get it serviced, whatnot like that, because I said I'm not gonna go out buy a new TV, because it's the last thing I want to do, right? So need to spend more money. I mean, the kids' birthdays coming up this weekend, right? So it's like, no. So I take another TV, the other TV from the main living room, and I put it into the dining room. So at least we have a backup TV and whatnot like that. And so I swap all sorts of TVs around because I got a bunch of them. And this one was doing the same thing. It wasn't turning on and off and on and off. It would turn on when we're standing in front of it at a specific area in the living room, and then the second we would move away from there, it would shut off. So now we're just like, now we're getting spooked, right? Because it's like, well, wait a minute, you're turning on and then you're turning off the second we move. We come back and it would turn back on, not touching anything, and not, you know, everything around it is unplugged. It's like, okay, I'll use a different socket maybe. So I started playing around with different sockets and exchanged different sockets and stuff. And then it was ending up, when the TVs were plugged in the socket that it's normally designed for the TV, it was just shutting on and off, on and off, on and off. When I took a couple of extensions, thinking maybe because these are only two-prong plugs versus three-prong plugs, so I said, well, maybe it's, you know, some kind of interference there or something like that. So I said, I'll take a two-prong plug, an extension, and then I'm running a bunch of extensions from the living room to the kitchen where it's plugged into the wall, and now the TV is absolutely fine, but it's got to be, it cannot be in its regular resting area for that TV. So I have to move it out onto the living room coffee table, because putting it where it was on the actual TV stand still does the same thing. The second I walk at a certain angle of the TV, not just me, mind you, okay? Right? So no, I'm not bad juju, right? But talk about weird, man. Super weird. So yeah, you should see the setup that I have right now. Maybe I'll grab some pictures and whatnot and post that up onto this so you can actually see what I've had to do. So I don't know. First off, thank God I didn't go out and buy a brand new TV, and then I would have come home, plugged that in, and it would have been the same damn thing. And I would be like, nope. So I guess right now what I'm gonna do again is go out to the store and go out and buy all new receptacles, buy new light switch just in case, I don't know, and sugar honey iced tea, load up beer or something really strong just to try and decompress from this. So yesterday, work, weird wacky doodle stuff going on. Yesterday afternoon, iPhone acts up and just decides to gobble away at all my notes. Come home, and then my TV's now on the blitz. So it's just like, holy smokes, like what else? Like seriously. Anyways. Other than that, all is good. So, still doing the gym almost on a nightly basis, so that's really good. I definitely feels nice to burn some energy. But you know, the problem is, it's funny. You do gym, and I was there for almost 2.5 hours last night. And I'm not just like diddle-daddling around. Like, I'm pushing and pushing and working hard. Like, I'm aching every morning. But not pain, just ache, which is good. And then it's just like I come home at midnight, because I do generally like from 12 to midnight, 10 to midnight, or so last night I did from 10 till almost 12:30. Come home and it's just like bing, wide awake until like 2 o'clock, and it's just like holy smokes. So you know, it has its super benefits where, you know, it gets you into shape and stuff, but has the flaws too, because it just kind of really, you know, boosts you up and so anyways, we'll see. That worked now, so I shall bid adieu on that, and I'm still fogging up, so strange, talking too much, that's why, too much hot air. Anyways, I'll talk to you guys later, take care. Hopefully I'll get that TV thing resolved, because I mean, that's definitely a pain in the butt. Ooh, hello Shirley, how are you? So alrighty, talk to you guys later, bye. Well, today started off pretty sad, and then yesterday was absolutely just a serious write-off. That kind of totally sucked, but now it's all changing because I just dropped off the FZ-07 only to pick up the FZ-09. Yes, my absolutely super duper favorite bike of all time. Anyways, yes. Hello everybody, it's Dyer, Rob Dyer from It's a Dyer Thing. End of the day, oh my gosh, it's been a long, long day. I still trying to catch up from vacation time actually, so now it's been 3 days just trying to catch up on all the emails. And so, like I said, finally at the end of the day, so it feels so good to get on the absolutely my most favorite motorcycle of all time, the 2016 Yamaha FZ-09. Oh, there's Scott, here's my bossy bossies. Let it warm up. Let's go. Ah. That's it. We are out of here in 3, 2, 1. Ooh. Go. Bye-bye. So different than the than compared to the FZ-07. This thing is just, it's on steroids. It's a motorcycle on steroids. Ooh, I'm so excited. I love it. So I sent a message off to Sage this morning. I'm like, oh, I gotta take the other one back. I got the blues. And he's kind of like, wow, what do you mean I got the blues? Ah, that's all I was saying. It's just, I got the blues. I got the blues. Seeing if he was going to figure out that I got the Yamaha blues. So, oh my God, I love this bike. I so love this bike. I am so going to buy this bike. This is Daddy's bike. Oh. The power. Gotta, you know what, first thing I would do though is I would raise the height of the bar a little bit, and that seat, I'm not gonna say cushier seat, but it kind of tends to want to grab your middle region, let's call it, and kind of shifting you forward as it's grabbing that backwards, if you know what I mean, where you got to be on the throttle to kind of be semi-comfortable, right? Because otherwise, yeah, it kind of, and all your front portion, if you know what I mean, tends to go to the rear of your middle portion, kind of a little bit rough there. So kind of like shave the seat a little bit, or swap the seat out for a comfort seat style thing. I'm sure there's multiple options out there. We shall see. Anyways, I'm just happy now I got this bike back again for a few days. So it would be nice to ride. Tomorrow's Thursday, so hopefully we'll do a Lakeshore and Leslie bike night. I'm gonna go through the yellow, bad me. That's okay. I did it safely beside this other car. Who would have taken the impact if anything got boom-boomed? If anything got boom-boomed. So. Hello, my little FZ. She's such a sweetheart. I know they normally say, oh, you should ride it kind of like more like a motocross, like sitting more on the tank and stuff like that, but I don't like that. I like a little bit further in the back because it balances off when you want to do quick takeoff, I guess let's call it a quick takeoff. Ooh, that dude had purple hair. Dude guy had purple hair. Ah, I love the sound of this bike. And this is stock exhaust. So, and it's so light, like the front end. There's just, it's so... Anyways, I'd like to figure out a way that I can add sound of the bike while I'm talking without the ambient noise of the wind, because it's so nice to, oh yeah, maybe if I ride around with my head close to the to the gas tank or something. Woohoo! Here we go. Hello everybody, it's Rob. Playing with my utmost favorite motorcycle. Boom, boom, boom. And legs down. It's just balances so nicely. It's such a beautiful bike. Oh, it's so hot. I said I'll wear a sweater. I'll wear long sleeves now when I'm riding just to kind of be, you know, good example, because riding in t-shirts and riding in none gear is not very good. But thing is, we do 50, 60 kilometer an hour street riding for 3 kilometers is the distance between home and work. So it's like I don't even get to be at highway speeds or anything. So I'm not saying that, oh, you shouldn't wear gear and all that. Absolutely, I wear gear when I go out, do some serious riding. But gear is only there to help you with road rash and stuff like that. And yes, you can still get road rash at low speeds, but it's I've bailed many times before as well on streets, and it doesn't do that much. Now highway speeds, yeah, you definitely want leather and stuff and whatnot. So but until I get onto the highways, I'm not so worried about it. And leather and all that does not stop bones from breaking, which is what happens at low speeds, as things kind of tend to grab on a little bit more. And if anything's going to happen within work and one and two, and then this is my turn. Ay-ya. Just amazing how it just kind of goes and goes and goes. That first gear just goes forever and ever and ever. Please, I'm just on the other side of you. Let me come through. Ay-ya-ya. Okay, my turn. Okay, gotta go home, shower, change, go get kids. Thank you. And I got booked massage for tonight. Been doing a lot of gym, so my back is kind of sore. And I'll go over, see our local little place, Ocean Health. Really good little facility, proper RMT. So you, and my turn. Yeah, and we are home. Talk about a long commute, eh? That's nothing hard. I'm home. Oh yes, I know. You behave. And, well, that's it. I do appreciate all the support and the comments, feedbacks, subscriptions, likes, dislikes, whatever. You know what? You're allowed. It's a free country. Write what you want. Until next time, I hope you all take care, ride safely, have fun, enjoy, and we'll catch up. Bye.